So today's topic we're going to go into is what actually makes a high ball offer. How is it that our doctors turn a low ball offer into a high ball offer? Obviously, that's a big topic and you can't cover the details of that in 20 minutes. But let's go into exactly how that works. And we're just going to reverse engineer it right now. We're just going to go backwards. And we're going to start with, now remember, this is from a medical perspective. This is not legal advice. And again, I'm Dr. Paul. I've opened 77 offices in 20 states, saw thousands of patients, expert witness testimony. I teach personal injury, continuing legal education to doctors and attorneys. Never lost a case in court. As a matter of fact, I'm the only chiropractor to beat the United States government by trial in court. So that's what all this is based on, and I've authored 10 books now. So let's go backwards, and from the medical side, there's four potential injury awards. And again, this is not meant for you to be read. This is really just an outline for me. It's kind of chicken scratch. But there's the medical injury award, the impairment, the pain and suffering, and the prognosis. So those are the four potential injury awards. Now, I will say this. Typically, when we're dealing with the low impact soft tissue spinal injury, individually, none of these will typically bring a policy limit award. But what happens is when you combine all four of them, in other words, when you get injury award for each of these four individually, typically those will pretty comfortably max out a policy limit award. And that's what gives these kind of results that we're talking about here.